Ladies and gentlemen, I'm about to give you 3 tips to help you start your YouTube channel. No, these are tips that help me personally, but they might not help you, so take that with a grain of salt. Let's get into it, shall we? First tip that helps for me is called consistency. Now, honestly, you're not gonna immediately grow to fame like PewDiePie or anything else. It's gonna take time. I've been doing this for roughly 3 years, probably more. But I got lucky, so, you know. But consistency is basically the best thing you can do at the very short rate. Yes, your videos may be crap, but trust me, in the future, they'll look that as, you know, very vintage arts of the past. Trust me, I go on to my YouTube videos and I think, damn, how did I do that? Or damn, how did I do that? Trust me, consistency is going to help you a lot. Not to mention, it's going to actually make you more, I guess, put it into the algorithm. So, yeah, consistency is really good. Quality. Now, quality is a really loose term when I say quality. It's more or less knowing what the hell you are doing. Now, with me personally, I do commentary, gaming, and animation. I haven't done a commentary video because I've been working on some stuff. But that's besides the point. Know what you are gonna do. Know what you want to do. And know what it's gonna take to pretty much rise to the top in that situation. Such an example with Diamond Animations. Diamond Animations is an animator, and he's doing pretty fucking damn good for himself. Look at me, for example. I do commentary, gaming, and animation. Now note, my commentary videos take more views and other stuff like that, but people also know me for gaming and other stuff. I'm not really trying to raise up in any of those specific fields, I'm just trying to bring content. Now, I don't know about Diamond Animations, but he's doing a pretty good job. But think about gaming, for example. This is the best way I can describe to you what your experience on YouTube is going to be like when you start up a gaming channel, or literally anything else. Imagine that you're going down a freeway. You look to your left because you are hungry, and you're looking for food. Now, your little YouTube channel is way the fuck, like 2 miles away. But to the left of the viewer, there is a McDonald's and a Burger King. Pretty much all the popular brands of food. Now, they go to that place because they think, I would love a burger. I would love some McDonald's, you know, stuff like that. But occasionally, you'll get that one person who does not want to eat there, and instead will go forward and see, this place looks pretty interesting. Let me take a look at it. That's the best way I can describe to you what a YouTube channel is going to be like. On top of that, it's going to be very strenuous. Like, very strenuous. And, But onward to the next point. Now, this next point is more or less a point that you really need to learn, or a point that you really need... I had to learn the hard way. And that is stress and taking breaks. Now, YouTube is a very stressful job, if you can get that far, to become a job. But YouTube is what I like to call a very stressful job. You are constantly on the search for pretty much stuff that is going to attract viewers. Basically, you're a fisherman looking for the best type of bait. And I know that's kind of saying shit with the current YouTube days using clickbait and stuff like that, but that's the best way I can describe it to you. You're a fisherman. You have a hook, but you don't have any bait. So, that's a YouTube channel for you. But pretty much, you need to learn when to take a break, and when it is perfect to take a break. Me, personally, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing, so I take breaks here and there. But then again, that's just my channel. But when it comes down to, like, gaming videos, I've seen a lot of people talk about the same issue that they currently have, which is, I don't know if I'm doing this for myself, or I don't know if I'm doing this for the people, or I'm not happy with it because they're super depressed, because they're not happy. Which is really fucking bad, because I suffer with the same thing. I try to do content now that I'm happy with, and not that I fucking despise. And other YouTubers are trying to do the same, and most likely you're gonna have to suffer with it too. Unless you actually get popular on the stuff that you like to do. So, yeah. My best bet is to take a break once you feel worn out, because burnout fucking sucks. And most importantly, know what to do under those circumstances, and talk to people about that, because it gets really bad after a while, and I know that I suffer with it. But yeah, these are my tips, tricks, and most importantly, the things that I had to go through on my YouTube channel. I hope that it helps you in a personal way. I don't think it will help you, but you know, food for thought, pretty much, because everyone is different. Everyone's going to suffer differently. Everyone's going to have a different experience on YouTube. And most importantly, everyone's going to get popular at different speed. I was lucky enough to screw up and basically pledge my channel into commentary, but I'm trying to take that out of commentary and more or less show introduction to gaming. So, yeah. I hope you enjoyed. Good luck on your YouTube channel. And most importantly, hold that leash tight. You're definitely going to be for the next episode. And...